Hey there. Welcome to Life Noggin. Everyone in the human world is stuck inside at the moment. Well, at least they should be. While staying at home may sound like a dream scenario to some of you homebodies out there, there are some important things to keep in mind when you're spending weeks at a time inside if you want to stay healthy, physically and mentally. All that time indoors can lead to certain medical issues that can worsen as the days stack up. One of the risks comes from a major part of our home environment, the air we breathe. Things like mold, dust, fibers, smoke, pet dander, cleaning products, all contribute to indoor air pollution, which can be up to 5 times more concentrated than outdoor air pollution. Indoor pollutants can trigger asthma or allergy attacks, or cause irritation, headaches, or flu-like symptoms. So rev up those purifiers, I sure am sneezy. Another issue with being cooped up for so long is the lack of sun exposure. We touched on this in a previous video, but it's definitely worth repeating. Sunlight is your primary source of vitamin D. Without direct exposure, your levels of vitamin D will drop, which could put you at risk for poor bone health, multiple sclerosis, and even cancer. Sun exposure also helps regulate your circadian rhythm, which tells your body when to sleep, release hormones, and perform other bodily functions. An irregular rhythm caused by decreased exposure to sunlight can lead to sleep disorders, obesity, and depression. To get your daily dose of sun, if you can, spend some time outside. At the very least, open up the curtains or windows and bask in the sunlight for a bit. Be a plant. Soak it up. The World Health Organization has recommendations for ways to stay physically and mentally healthy when stuck at home for a while. And guys, it might be a long while. Eating healthy is a great start, as it can actually boost your immune system. So limit your sugar, salt, fat, and alcohol intake. And now more than ever, don't smoke. It can make virus symptoms worse and increase your risk of getting seriously sick. You should also exercise for around 30 minutes each day. If you can't safely go outside for a run, you can find plenty of home workout classes on YouTube. And take small breaks throughout the day just to get up and move around. For good mental health, do something that gets your mind off the crisis. Whether that be reading a book or playing video games, it's important to take a mental break too. I love to play Animal Neighbors for the Blocktendo Swatch. I love these non-copyrighted villagers, except this one. This one will be exiled. Advice from psychology experts to promote good mental health during this time include creating a routine such as showering and putting on new clothes to create a sense of normalcy, staying connected with family and friends to reduce loneliness or depression, keeping entertained with activities or TV to stay mentally active, and focusing on positive news stories instead of doom scrolling. It's not as cool as it sounds. It's actually super depressing. We all have our part to play in this pandemic. I know it's a scary time, but staying at home right now is a vital step to stopping the spread and saving lives. So what have you been doing to pass the time indoors? Do you have any suggestions for the people watching? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Stay home, stay safe, and keep on thinking.